G'day viewers, welcome to Australia Worldwide Gaming. Welcome aboard.
Welcome to Saturday Night on the Rails, episode 75, with the Aussie Don.
Saturday Night on the Rails with you guys. G'day to you all. Here's our train. Inner City Class 395. Very nice. We've got another update to the billboards, ladies and gentlemen. There we go with that one. At long last, we have an update. At long last, we have an update to the billboards. He said it's the final update, so final update for now, I say. Great job once again. Fantastic. Then there's two people that are doing the update now. The same dude that, you know, I don't know if you guys remember a fair while ago, I had an announcement, one where they give announcements at the stations and they used to cut halfway off. Now, the same dude has actually done Southeastern High Speed one as well. So, I haven't downloaded that one because he's already explained that it's because of the way that Dovetail have done the announcements, the original announcements. There's only a certain amount of time that they can do it. That's why they get cut off. So now he's actually explained that. I thought that might have been the case anyway. Anyway. I haven't gotten that one. I've got the original. I still think it's the best one. Southeastern High Speed kicking it off here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to Ashford International. So we're on the new part of the route, Southeastern Extension. Playing Train Sim World 3 on PC.
If you're new to our YouTube channel, welcome aboard. If you're a returning customer, welcome back to the station. Punch your ticket and click the subscribe button now. Join our family of over 2,400 subscribers. The Aussie Don will love you to be on board our amazing train.
Yeah. Alright. Here we are in a city. It's one of my favourite designs, actually. It's quite good. Here we go. Some gameplay of East Coast Mainline, East Coast Way coming up later on as well. It'll be the first time I've actually gone to the East Coast Way on Train Sim World 3 era as well, so that's gonna be really cool. Can you believe it? I haven't been to the East Coast Way yet. Come on, what's happening? What's happening there? Thank you.
First stop is Stratford International.
So there's a couple of billboards here. Got the nine pieces for $5.99. We know what that is. Help is out. Fleet next. G'day, Andrew. So a nice little update once again for the Southeastern High Speed Extension Enhancement mod. And I've seen that the London Midland one, a couple other dudes actually, there's three of them combined, and they've done one as well. But yeah, I've never really liked them ones because of the cutoffs with the announcements. So it's good to see that in the description now, creator of the mod has actually noted the fact, the reason why behind the announcements being cut off, so yeah, it's understandable. So I don't know, I might give that one a whirl anyway, see, compare the difference between them, different types of billboards that evolved with that one. The Pringles machine, I do note the Pringles machine I've seen has been changed for a Coca-Cola venting machine, which is pretty cool. Thank you. So when we go to the East Coast later on, folks, you might hear the sounds a little bit different on the Freak 77 as well, because I've got a sound mod I've just actually installed to it. So it's going to be sound modded. I do believe I've got the enhancements on the East Coast mainline as well. I've seen somebody actually posted that there's a cow in one of the vehicles. I'm not too sure what route it is, but I've seen it. There's a cow actually, it looks like it's driving one of the vehicles. It's just pretty funny actually. See if we get that lag still around just before we get to Ashford. There's a little area just right on top of it, pretty much coming into station. It just lags it out like dog's balls. It's strange actually, because it wasn't doing that before we got the official launch live update. It was all right in the first 4 days, and since we've had the official core update, been lagging. Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how many views we get tonight, folks, because we are battling the big, massive blockbuster NRL finals game here tonight. Hopefully Souths beat the Sharks, because I am a St. George fan, and we hate the Sharks with a passion. We hate them. They hate us, we hate them. That's what happens when you're in rival sport, your rivals in a certain sport, you know, you always get your rivals. It's all part of it. Yeah, unfortunately our team didn't make the finals, so I don't have to worry. Ooh, slow down. Oh, no. Ah, I stuffed it. Shit, how do I fix that? Might have to reset the whole bloody trip. Bugger. Cleared it. Good. Got it. Yeah, I know the circuit breaker's fucking gone on me. shit. No. How can I? All right, I got the vaults up. Yes! Fucking bank cross. That's the first time I've been able to actually get it up and running again. I've been struggling to trip that bloody back on every time I've done that. Now I'm delayed. I didn't panic that time, that was the problem. I was like, oh no, unfortunately I'm gonna have to change, fix it up and go again. And I'm like, oh. Yeah, I haven't been able to work that out, how to get that buzzer off, finally figured it out. Well, hopefully when I get spud again tonight. We've been spud already, what, we're not even half an hour into it. Great. I have to say, folks, I think that this, just here, the marker is too far, it needs to be further down the platform, in my liking. I think it's, it's on the platform, yeah, fair enough, but if you had the double, you know, all that's going to be off. I don't think that should be more further, maybe down around here, you know. Got the newspapers, have the newspapers changed, or has he got the same ones? Yeah, he's got the same ones. He's changed the newspapers. I would have liked to have seen the newspapers changed, actually, but anyway. Miles, here we go. Yeah, so I like this design, folks. If you are a fan of it, then I highly suggest just type up 395 up in the search area. Folks, I'm going to tell you right now, if you are getting stuck like I am with the endless wheel of death on the Creators Club on the actual game itself, then I suggest to go to the Creators Club website, and you can put in your Dovetail account on there, and whatever platform you play on, it will recognize it the next time you fire up your Train Sim World game. They definitely work at the website. So that's how I do it, so I've given up with just trying to subscribe on the actual game itself. It never works. Even if you log on, log off, it doesn't work. I wasn't aware of a Creators Club actual website until recently. And I thought, where were you all these months? I didn't even know nothing about it, so yeah, it's good. So I went to the forums and actually said that there should be a site, and I was like, well, I didn't realise that there actually was until I actually posted something up on the forums. If anybody knows about the screenshot competition this week, let us know as well, because I've been trying to look for the winners for it all day. It was supposed to have been announced at a certain time on Friday on the UK time. I think it was midday UK time or something. But I haven't seen nothing on the forums for the winners, because I was involved in it, obviously. I had my couple up on there. I was not expecting to win anyway, because there were so many great photos. I have to say, probably the one that I really think should win it is the Bakerloo Line 1 in the total darkness with the big lightning bolt at the back. Man, it got a lot of likes, and I have to say, it is a fantastic photo. So if that one, I would say, will be well deserved, because it is really, really nice. I like how the lightning reflects around the tube stock. And then you get the bolt in the background. Stunning detail. And there was a few other great ones as well. Man, I got a nice, beautiful screenshot. Actually, I still haven't posted it up on the Facebook page. I got a nice, beautiful screenshot yesterday on the home pass with a big lightning bolt in the holding yard with all the containers around. I had a right zoom up on the front of the train. I had the Creators Club Union Pacific, actually the latest paint job Union Pacific as well. For roof cam. I don't know if that's a bug or not, but I've been noting ever since the release of Train Sim World that this fan is not working. And if I turn on the fan, roof aircon, let's see if that works now. Yeah, those fans should be working, so I don't know what's going on there. It's Fabishing over there in the distance. G'day railway guy, how you going, buddy? Yeah, it's a nice design. Now, I've got a couple of the inner city ones, and I thought this one was quite unique. It's got the front here, it's a little bit different, and I like it. No, I don't mind the front of it, actually. It's quite cool. Yeah, I like how it's got the yellow. It's different. the other design I've got of it is actually the full, there's a full design, not 100% certain. I just, as soon as I seen Inner City, I thought, oh yeah, subscribe to it. British Ace earlier run out another uploaded video. He done a Bakerloo line, another Bakerloo line one with the updated timetable. I'll do another Bakerloo live stream later in the, later this week, come or next week I should say. We're not on Sunday yet, are we? Sunday's a new week for us, so we always say Sunday, new week. Or Monday's a new week. What do you reckon, Monday, Sunday? Sunday's a relaxing day, eh? It is sort of for me because I like, I'll do a couple streams and then I do my American Truck Simulator live stream, and that never gets as many views as the train stuff that I do. Like I explained, I'd mod for American Truck Simulator, so always got something fresh on there. So I do the skins for the trucks and trailers. Why is that 45 or so? Should not be doing that. That's better. Let's see if it's changed any of my other settings. Yeah, it has. Text quality. Texture quality high, ultra very high. Why has that gone to 8? What the hell? Lol. I forgot I ended up putting it in ultra earlier today. There's not much difference, to be honest. It doesn't really change the detail that much. My liquid cooling system might have been overheating then. I'm thinking, what the hell, because I've had overheating issues lately. I'm like, what the hell's going on? It's not even warm. the only place it should lag is the end of Ashford. Like I explained, it's been doing it since the official launch. But it's not too bad in the first early access area. Folks, I'm going to mute the mic while I kick back and watch a bit of the NRL finals match. We've got South Sydney up against the peptide son of a bitches. Oh, Cronulla. Can't stand them. See you guys soon. Where someone needs to do a sound mod to actually make the windscreen wipers quiet. It's annoying. I have to say, it's annoying. Sounds like the windscreen wipers are scratching the window and they're just, yeah, very well worn windscreen wipers. Again, my butt. Bullshit. I hate the six again ruining rugby league, I swear. It's just ruined the game. Like, I remember the game was good back in the days, you know, when it was, you know, we had the biff, you know, and big hits and, you know, little petty fights, you know, here and there, you know. None of this bloody, go to the video referee, all this bullshit, you know. It used to be good when they had the sidelines at the back and you used to have the calls on the field. None of this fucking bunker crap. Go, 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 go! Go! Oh, they're gonna get him. Go! Oh, I fucking dropped the ball. Was that Latrell? It was too. Now it should lag around after these tunnels here. You watch the lag, you watch the frame rate. As soon as we get out of these tunnels. See, there it is. As predicted, there's all the spiking. Look at all that. That's what it's been doing ever since the launch. It's just been spiking up like hell. And it wasn't doing that on the first 4 days of the early access. It was smooth as. Whatever they did at the core update. I hate how they drop off the chair like that. They gotta stop that. Right. They never used to have that, and it's just, yeah, I don't really like it, to be honest. Right, you're on Saturday Night on the Rails, episode 75. You're with the Aussie Don. Thank you very much for joining me. Sorry about that little lag there. It always does it there at the end. It's been doing that since the launch. And, yeah, I don't have to continue to explain myself about it. It needs to be fixed. But we all know optimization is the major killer of train sim world. Right. I'm going to head to the East Coast way for the first time. First time in train sim world 2. Ah, 3. Jeez, oh, don't say train. Ah! Kill me now. Let's go with the Tesco. We're going to go to Hastings on this one. Oh, bloody hell. Oh, no, they're going to get the ball again. Oh. I didn't want to close it. Okay, we've got a Tesco. Yeah, I don't really like that sound, to be honest. That's just way overpowering. Yeah, I don't like that. So this is one of the reasons why I didn't really want to get the sound mod anyway. I suppose it's, go, South! Let's go! Get into them! Get rid of those peptide scumbags! I don't really like these sounds, so I'm gonna definitely take this sound mod off. Very disappointed, but it has got announcements apparently, so let's see if they work. That's half time. Yeah, 18-0, let's go. Approaching Lees. I reckon this cant is a load of bullshit. Shouldn't be this slow. Calling at Berwick, Holgate, head to Park, Eastbourne, and then the rest of it, Hampton Park, Bexhill, St Leonard's, St Leonard's Warriors Square, and Hastings, and that's where they should do the extension to. Or they could take it to the other part of Ashford International, and then it could be like a combined big link. There's a lot of great options, I tell you right. All right, Berwick next stop. One route I'd love to see extension, but can they do an original train symbol one route as an extension? That's the question. speaking of simulators, our other great simulator we have, American Truck Simulator, I see that they're finally going to be bringing the other part of they're going to be bringing another extension to the final piece of the puzzle, I should say, for the Wyoming map. It's good news. So that means they've done a very good job to it. They've run a couple updates for it. The Texas one, because they were talking about this, when they did the first part of the extension, they talked about it weeks before the announcement for the release for Montana. So Texas could still be on this update. I'm looking forward to the Texas DLC. It'll be the best one ever. Yeah. I reckon we're gonna get DLCs from now on, where they'll eventually, you know, with other little updates, they'll add more to that particular map. Yeah, that's gone quiet, eh? Because there was supposed to be another phase for the California map, and they were going to do you know how they took away the city, and they said they were going to add another one. That's on the next phase, and I'm not sure if they got to go to LA or anything. But LA needs to be reconstructed. It needs to be way bigger than what it is. So. The 30 zone's on the opposite end if you're coming from Eastbourne. So it's after the station.
Yeah.
Coming into Berwick now. I still think that this is the greatest route of all time. It's beautiful. But yeah, I love to see an extension. Out of any route that needs that I like to see an extension, it's this one. It would actually make me smile big time. The grin on my face would be, yeah. It's just, this route is the route that is what really got me hooked on Train Sim World in the first place. Like, I played it before East Coast Way and everything, and it's, you know, it was all right, I liked it and everything, but, it, you know, this is the route that what really got me started. I need to use the toilet, folks, so I do apologise. I will be back in a couple seconds, so stand by. I will be back with the continuation of our gameplay here tonight. We've got lots more to come after East Coast Way, so don't go anywhere. We are on Saturday Night on the Rails, episode 75. You're with the Aussie Don. Sorry about that, folks. Make your calls. Okay, our final stop at Eastbourne is coming up. We've got plenty more action coming your way after this one. Here on Saturday Night on the Rails, episode 75. Okay. That's our run on the East Coast way. First time on Train Sim World Freeze Arrow. Very good, alright, there we have that one. So gold medal, no surprise, 9,058 points. Alright. You're on Saturday Night on the Rails, episode 75 with the Aussie Don. G'day to you all, coming to you from our studio here in the east coast of Australia. And here we go now with some more gameplay. Alright. Do 11:46. Here we go. Okay. Here we are at... g'day, William. I see... design. Let me just change the settings again while we're here, because we're on the really good one before. Don't really need to. Yeah, so you got the LGV Mediterranean, so that means you got the extra layers now for the southeastern high speed. It's like when you know, if you got the Spirit of Steam, you get that, the extra two services that they give you for the steam coach ones, which unfortunately one of them is in the darkness of the night time, so it doesn't look nice when you stream, especially when you're streaming it. So I refuse to do it. The other one's pretty damn long. It's a long trip. So I've got to concentrate here because I am using LZB. I got LZB on, but there's no LZB for this particular logo. I've got PZB on it. Okay, we have a flashing light up here, so we have to be aware of that. What's going on? Why is it not going? I hate it when it doesn't do that. It doesn't trigger the speed. I fucking annoyed. Ah. I acknowledged it. Yeah, no way. Now it's starting to piss me off with that shit. Ah, oh, for fuck's sake, fuck this route. Why is it not triggering? I'm pressing the fucking button. Back shortly.
Thank you.
suck shit, Cronulla scumbags. Oh, well, the Cronulla Sharks have been eliminated from the footy season. Suck shit. Message from all of the Red V Army. Suck shit. Oh, Gravesend next stop. It's our final stop, actually. For the train to come out of the station at Gravesend. And that's what it was last time. It might not be the same this time, but that's the more likely. Oh no, we got the green. What is the case this time? Not nothing there. Okay, fair enough. Don't forget, all our main shows are back again next week. All aboard, Monday night, all aboard with the Aussie Don on Monday with Train Simulator Classic. Tuesday on Tuesdays with Train Sim World 3. Midweek World of Trains on Wednesday. And the return of the community vote for this Wednesday as well, folks. We're going to be putting a community vote together. You guys get to choose between three routes. I'll be putting the community vote on the YouTube channel later on today. Invading will close on Tuesday. Okay. Gold medal, very nicely done. All right. So you head to our community area of our YouTube channel, folks. That's where we give you all the details. Well, when I get the chance to put all the details together for all our live streaming action. So you got all the information of our main event live streams that we do on our channel. And there's community votes there from time to time for our Train Sim World midweek World of Trains. So it is returning, and the first one for the Train Sim World free era this coming Wednesday. So look, do go there and vote. You can only vote once, so cast your vote wisely. There'll be three routes to choose from, and I'll post that on the channel later on today. All right. We've got one more last run. Let's do one more, yeah? All right. Got a live stream in 36 minutes from now. I'm going to be bringing a live stream of City Skylines. So join us for that one. That would be great. City Skylines action. And don't forget, our main event tomorrow is American Truck Simulator with our Sunday Night Lying the Highways live stream. I'll bring another truck and trailer combination out. I'm going to be bringing out a fuel tanker tomorrow night, so that's going to be lots of fun. All right. A B-double fuel tanker.
When it rains, it pours. When it rains, it pours. When it rains, it pours. When it rains, it pours.
I'm not going to do the PZB. I can do it on this route. I was like, should I? Should I? Yeah. Nah, you know why? Because I want to see if there's any lightning. I thought you'd go do Seifer, actually. Let's just do a cruise. Let's just cruise the final one. Yeah. Here we go. Whoa. Oh, see that bolt on the side there.
She's a nasty whip.
Oh, look at that lightning bolt in the distance. Well, that was a great way to end our live stream here today. Beautiful thunderstorm on the Rue Austin, one of my favorite German routes. Very, very nicely done. So that was short and sweet. Nice way to pick up a few little action points there. Well, thank you very much for coming along for this week's edition of Saturday Night on the Rails, episode 75. It has been an absolute honour and privilege bringing you this live stream. And yeah, we weren't on last Saturday because I was away last weekend. And yeah, I am home this weekend. But I can tell you guys that I have got a lot of stuff coming up. So there's going to be a few weekends that I'm going to be away. In particular, on the start of October, I am turning 40 years old. At the start of October, on the 4th of October, actually. So I'm an old bastard and I'm old school. So I'm having a party that weekend, so it's going to be awesome. So I'm going to be away from the studio because, yeah, I'm going out with all the boys and that. So it's going to be lots and lots of fun. So, yeah, I'll be away on that particular weekend. And, it's a grand final weekend as well, so I'm going to be, you know, away for a few days, so don't blame me if I'm not back until, like, Monday, Tuesday, that particular week, so I'll be a few days off. But, yeah, I think I deserve it because, I've been pumping like crazy for weeks now, and, I've had last weekend off, and that was the first weekend I've had off in quite a while. And then, yeah, I've got a few things coming up as well. My best mate's little son's christening. So got a lot of great stuff to do. So do note, folks, that I will try to get some uploaded videos while I am away from all that. And if I can't, then there is plenty of gameplay on that channel to last your lifetime. Man, there's days on end of gameplay. Over 4.5 years of gameplay, so no fear. We've got all the train action. We've got the dedicated Train Sim World 2020 playlist, which is the Train Sim World 1 playlist. We've got the Train Sim World 2 playlist with around 1,100 videos. We've got the Train Sim World 3 playlist, almost 70 videos already. Wow. And continues to grow. Thank you very much for watching this week's edition, by the way, and we will see you on the rails again sometime soon. More action coming up on Sunday for Train Action with Train Simulator Classic and Train Sim World 3, and coming up in around about 23 minutes from now, I'll be back with some City Skylines live streaming action. Have a great day, stay safe and stay healthy. Peace. Thank you.